Hello friends, this is DK Gautam and thank you for joining Interview Point. So in this video, I am going to talk about how to import data into the database through CSV file. Okay, so now let's get started. Before going to start this video, if you haven't subscribed my YouTube channel, then please subscribe my YouTube channel. Here you will get all the latest interview questions and all the POS application video here. Here is the playlist. You will get all the POS application video here. Okay, so now in this I am going to create a form like this. So this is a text box. I want to click, I will click on this select button and one window will open to select the CSV file, and then I want to import the complete data into the database. Okay, so open our IDE Visual Studio. I am going to create one form here. Okay, so add new item. Okay, just click on the Windows form, FRM, data import. Okay, just click on the add button here, a form will open. So I need to create this type of form. Okay, so I want to show you something. So this is the item table I have with me. So this is the data. So I want to import the complete data into the database. So first of all, I need to create this CSV file of this database. So actually I have already created the file, CSV file. I'm just going to show you. So this is the CSV file that I have created. So I will import this file into the database. Okay, so lookup code, item name, department ID, category ID, cost. So before that, delete this complete data from the table. Okay, and this, now you can see there is no data in the database. So I want control box, I don't want. So select false, data import will be the text. So this code I already have created. So first I need to put, so common controls button I want. This is the text box. Okay, so in the data grid view. Okay, these things I want this one more button here. Okay, so go to the property, change some properties here. Okay, if you don't know how to create the form, Windows form, please check my previous video. I'm not going to do complete designing here, but I will show you the mandatory things. Okay, so this will be the button select. Okay, so this is the select. And the button name will be button select. Okay, so change the property of this button, so it will be save. Suppose it will be okay. So just copy this and paste it here. So rename it, so it will be red. Okay, text will be close and the button name will be the btn close. Okay, so this is now done. So what I want, add some column header here, edit column. So what I want to do here, I want to add some column. So column name will be, so lookup code, item name, department ID, like this. I am going to add lookup code. Okay, you can, I want read only, and item name I want here. Item name, Okay, so like this, create the complete. Okay, so this is the lookup code. Copy it, don't forget data property. The same thing here. So like this, create all the form, all the header column. Okay, so I'm just going to move further. So I am done with this complete code. So what I want to do here, I want to this is the select button. So I want to open the dialog here, and this is the save, and this will be the close button. So in the close, I want to just close. Okay, so now I need to write some code here. So I have written all the code. So this is the code I have written here in the select file. So what I want to do here, I want to open this dialog here. Okay, I'm just going to copy paste all the code, complete code. So I will provide you the link in the description of this video. If you have any doubt, please ask me. So no worry, I will tell you everything. So this is the code. Okay, so I forget to give the name of this text box. So the txt file, txt file. Okay, now go. So the problem is I need to create this function, one more function here. So what I want to do here, just copy this complete code. I will tell you what I am using this code. So this is now done. So first understand the code. So this is the open file dialog. So this is the object I have created. So I want to open this file dialog. Okay, to select the file. So what it will do, this is a two variable that I have created, import and invalid items. Okay, so this is the source URL, that is the string variable. So dialog.file name is not equal to empty, so it means we must have selected one file. Okay, so we are validating the file here. File will be the .csv file, so that I have already showed you. So this is the data table. So I will get all the data into this data table. So this is the function I have created here. So add this reference, Microsoft.visualbasic. So now the error will be removed from here. Okay, so what I want to do here, I want to click on the store manager. At the time I want to open this dialog. Okay, so frm equal to new data import dot show dialog. Okay, so I'm just going to run it. So admin 123, click on the enter button, click on the store manager. So this file is open. Okay, so select, click on the select button, you will get this window will open to select the file. So I'm going to select this file here. So all the data is available here. So just understand the code. So what I did here, so this is the code. Okay, so this is just validation purpose I have written this code. So first column is my lookup code. So so first column name will be the lookup code. So these all are the fields, that four fields is the mandatory fields I must want. So lookup code, item name, department ID and price. So the four fields are mandatory. So if anything is not available, so I will just show the row in the red color. Okay, so I will increasing the invalid count also. So invalid item plus is equal to 1. Okay, so I will incrementing it by 1. So like that, if dg.item.row.count is equal to 0, so at that time we can consider that there is no data in the file. So what we can say, okay, you need to understand this code. Okay, so get table, so this will return the data table. Okay, so it will return the CSV data, so that I have created just this object CSV data. So I want to return this. So what it will do here, so it will, this is just for the validation purpose, this is the CSV reader, so it is the comma. So we are separating the record through the comma. Okay, so now this is the column, so I am reading the column, all the column here, and adding the column into the this data table. Okay, so this is the data table completed code here. So what I want to do here, just this is the done code, I just want to write the code into the save button. So I'm just going to copy and paste it here. Okay, for saving our time. So if you have any query, you can ask anytime. When I will be available, I will respond to you as soon as possible. And so this is the data table DT item. So I am reading all the data into the data grid view and data source. So this is just variable that I have created, and it is the count, because I just want to show the total how many records are inserted into the table. Okay, so this is the DB access that I have created one class for the database access purpose. So I need to provide the reference. Execute reader is nothing but that I have created into this file. So just I'm just going to show you the DB access and execute query function inside it. Okay, so DB access, this is the DB access class. Execute query, so this is the query. So what it is returning, it is returning a true and false. Okay, so that's why I just executed this code. So one query I will get in this query parameter, so this query will be executed here. Okay, so what I am doing here, I'm just getting the data into the, this is just for the validation purpose. So these are the four mandatory field. So this is the insert query. So insert into TV item. So this is the my table TV item. So there is no data in this. Okay, so when my query is completed, I have added one semicolon here to separate my query. So when it will comes into inside it, so it will count will be increased by one. When my insert item query will have the length greater than 5, it means it must have something. It means we can say, or we can say just like 0, then it also will executed no problem, because the initially it is empty. Okay, so it means we can say the data is, or the this variable must have some data. So at that time, what I am doing here, I am just executing this query by calling this function, and if it will return success, so I am just giving the message to the user fully, and total imported record is nothing but the count. Okay, so total imported record, so it will show the count. So just I am just going to admin 123. Okay, so store manager, select the file dkitems.csv. So this is the file. So this entry data I am not entering, so I'm just getting it from the directly. So you can see here, just get date function I'm using here. I'm just not reading that date from this column. Okay, so just click on the save button. So you can see item imported successfully, total imported record is 6. Okay, so now I'm just going to show into my SQL. So now see, item is imported. Okay, so thank you guys for watching this video. If you have any question, you can ask me. So blog, here you will get all the code here. Okay, I will provide you the link of this code into the description of this video, so no worry. Please subscribe our YouTube channel if you haven't subscribed. This is my Facebook page. You can ask me any question. Please follow me on my Facebook page, so you will get all the notification for my new videos. So this is my blog. You will get all the latest interview questions and all the code. Okay, so thank you guys.